It helps just take all the contaminants out. It's not one of those products where you have to do all the measuring and testing. You basically put it in, it takes care of your problem.
We're here with Matt Carberry, who's got one of the show talkers for sure. It's a new long-finned clownfish. How did you arrive at a long-finned clownfish?
Probably a stroke of luck, actually. We found a long-finned clownfish in a batch of regular clownfish. The parents are normal, fancy Oscillaris clownfish. And we found one little long-fin in there and separated them out. We didn't know if it would be genetic or not, if the next generation would show the long-fin trait. But what we've done is paired that up with another fancy Oscillaris, and now we have them producing some long-fin babies. So we brought two of those along to share and show at MACNA.
How long before you can put these on the mass market?
We're hoping to have them ready by spring or summer of next year, 2015. So we're working on making new pairs and being able to produce more of them.
Is it difficult to produce these things? I know you can kind of aquaculture clownfish and sort of get it to come out the way you want, but how is it with the long fins?
It's roughly the same. The only difference is they do tend to pick on each other, so we try to separate them out when we see the long fins so that they don't, you know, cause damage to each other. But otherwise, they're the same as any other Oscillaris or, you know, normal clownfish.
Is this like the guppy of the aquarium trade now?
Yeah, it's been called that. They say the guppification of the aquarium trade. This one's a little bit unique as far as a mutation, because most of the other differences or mutations for designer clowns are based on pattern or color. This is actually a structural change in the fish, so a little bit different, something new.
I would guess nature would select against this fish in the wild.
I would say, yeah, for sure. It wouldn't survive very long in the wild. They even have trouble swimming on strong current, so we're going to recommend when we do offer them for sale that people don't put them in reef tanks with very high turnover, so for that reason.
Sometimes designer clownfish can be very expensive. What do you anticipate that these will sell for?
We're actually hoping to produce enough of them to keep the price low so that the retail price is less than $100. That's our goal.
So maybe sometime in 2015?
Yep, we're hoping. We'll work on it.
Matt Carberry, Sustainable Aquatics, thank you very much.
Thanks so much.
Appreciate it.